Hello, this is RetroTK2, and today we're looking at the bulk rename utility program for Windows. We'll download it and see what it can do. So let's get started. Open up your browser of choice, type bulk rename utility into Google, and it should be the first link. Click the free download button, click the download bulk rename utility button, and when it's finished downloading, click the installer. Click yes on the UAC dialog. Super basic install here is, just follow the instructions and you'll be fine. Now the utility is completely free for private use, but if you want to use it in your business, you'll have to pay for it. Before we get into the whole workings of the program, I want to divert your attention to the BRU forum. Here you can find or ask any questions about how to use the utility. You can even see me on there, Ace, with an extra T for good measure. Ah, wonderful. And if you don't feel like talking to people, you can always check out the manual instead. The link to both are in the description, Ace. Now that all that's out of the way, let's get stuck in. There are two ways to open our newly installed rename utility. You can either type bulk rename into the search box and click on the program shortcut, or, and this is my preferred method Ace, we can right click on the file or folder we want to rename and click the bulk rename here selection from the dropdown. The advantage with this method is that it opens our utility at our file's location. Now this software does have quite an intimidating user interface Ace, but honestly it's really easy to use once you get the hang of it. I'm going to skip over the Regex option here Ace, since it is complicated enough to warrant its own separate video. If you'd like me to do a video on it, please leave a comment down below. Let's skip straight to the name section Ace. You have four options here. You can either keep the name as it is, remove the name entirely, replace the name with the text in the text field using the fixed option, or reverse the name. You'll notice that the result in the new name column is changing as I'm making these selections, Ace. This is our final result, and to make it official, we click the rename button in the bottom right corner. Doing this will bring up a warning dialog, basically saying you're about to change the names of X amount of files. If you prefer not to see this, Ace, uncheck the box beside Show this warning again and click OK. After that, you'll be hit with another dialog confirming the rename change. And just like before, we can uncheck the box beside Show this message again to speed up our renaming process. And as you can see in the left column, our selected file's name has changed. Now these renaming effects do stack Ace, and you can disable them individually if you like. If I select the reverse option again, you'll see our final result just like before. But if I uncheck the box at the top of the effects area, you'll see that I disable that effect. Easy peasy lemon squeezy is, so let's fly through these remaining effects. Our next one is the replace effect. Type in some text that is contained in the current name of the file and then type in the text you want to replace it with. Obvious, right Ace? Although slightly less obvious is how the effects stack. Here we can see that our text is replaced, but if I reverse our name effect as well, you'll see that only the name effect is applied. This is because the effects are applied in the order of 1 to 13, so do bear that in mind, Ace. The case effect, as the name would suggest, changes the case of the letters. Same upper and lower do exactly what you would expect them to. The title option capitalizes the first letter of all the words, Ace. And finally, the sentence option capitalizes the first letter and makes the rest lowercase. Fairly simple, Ace, but now we're going to get slightly trickier. This is the remove effect. First N is the number of characters you want to delete from the start of the name. So 6 would remove the first 6 characters. Nice. Similarly, last N removes that number of characters from the end of the name. From and to are ranges Ace, so if I input 10 and 15, I will remove the 5 characters within that range. Cars are characters, so if I type in T, we remove all the T's Ace. Words means words, of course, and we'll do something similar. The crop feature is pretty straightforward too, yes. Selecting before and typing out a string contained in the name will remove the characters before that string. Selecting after will remove the ones after your string. Obvious, I'm sure, yes, but then we get to the special option. This seems to be nothing at first, but watch what happens if I change the C to a star. Hey, it removes everything. Here we're using a wildcard Ace. This will remove all the characters within a character range, and it'll also remove the start and end characters too. So for example, if I type out D star K, our range starts at D and ends at K. If I increase the end range to W, you'll see we remove D, W, and all the characters in between. Yeah, I know, a little bit more advanced than we've been doing so far, yes. The checkboxes here will remove all of what they describe. So digits will remove all the digits, cars will remove all the letters, and accents will remove, well, accents. High is a weird one, yes. It removes high ASCII characters from the name. That's characters from 128 to 255. And if you're unsure what ASCII characters are, I'd say don't worry too much about this, yes. Trim will remove white spaces from the ends. DS will remove double spaces. And Sign will remove all the symbols. Fun, 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 yes. Lastly, leading dots will remove dots from the start of the name. Though, for whatever reason, it only works when you change crop to special and type a letter in the text field. Yeah, I have no idea why it's like that either, yes. The move copy effect moves or copies the first or last N characters to the start, end, or a position of your choice. I know, painfully obvious, yes. But perhaps less obvious is that you can have a separator at the start or end of the string being moved. Which is just wonderful. Let's check out the add effect. Prefix adds text to the start of your name, suffix adds text to the end of your name, and insert will insert text at the position specified in the @pause text field. If you check the world space checkbox, you'll add a space before each capitalized word. Moving on to the auto date effect. The mode dropdown adds the date to either the prefix, suffix, or not at all, yes. The type dropdown is the date you want to use. You can use today's date, which is the current selection on the dropdown list, but there is also the option to use the creation, date modified, or date access date from the menu too. Taken is for photos, yes, and is the date the photo was taken, of course. If you've updated the file's dates artificially, you can choose new from the menu list instead. FMT is the date's format, yes. The different formats should be pretty self-explanatory, though the custom option may cause you a bit of confusion. This uses parameters that you can add to the custom text field, yes. And hey, based on that, you can see the exact time that this was recorded. All of them are prefixed with a percentage symbol. I'm not going to go into them in this video, yes, just because it's getting long enough already, to be honest. There is a full list of parameters on page 25 of the manual, so be sure to check that out. Sep is our separator, yes, and is a good way to distance your date from your original name. Seg is our segments and makes the date much easier to read. Cent changes our year to either 4 or 2 digits. Off is our offset, yes, and seems to increase the R value by 1 each time. If it goes over the daily limit, then it will increment the date. Let's see a pen folder name. Name is our prefix, suffix stuff. Sep is our separators. But levels is something pretty different, yes. It will actually use the directory's path in the naming. I'm not exactly sure why you would ever want this, but it's cool nonetheless. The numbering effect is probably one of the biggest wins of this software, yes. Mode is your prefix, suffix, and insert, all that fun stuff. And the insert's position is controlled by the @ value. Start is the number we start at, and inc is how much we are increasing that number by per file. So 2 goes to 4 goes to 6, yes. Pad will add 0 to the start of the number, depending on the number of digits in that number. So if pad is set to 2 and our number is 2, it will display as 02. But if our number is 16, then no zeros are added. Sep is our separator, which we've seen before, yes, so no real need to comment on that. Now, break is a complete mystery to me, yes. From the manual, it says reset the auto number when the NNN character changes. E.g., enter 4 to cause the number to reset when the fourth character of the new name changes. Maybe I'm missing something obvious, yes, so please feel free to tell me in the comments below. I'll talk about the folder checkbox in a little bit, yes. Type is awesome and allows you to change the base of the actual numbers. So if you like, you can have binary. And you can even have hexadecimal, yes. Very cool indeed. Roman numerals only seems to change the case of the Roman numeral letters, which is a big shame, Ace. I was hoping it would change our numbering to Roman numerals, but c'est la vie. The extension effect deals with the file's extension, funnily enough. That's the .txt on the end of our files here, Ace. This is very like what we've done before. Uppercase, lowercase, and title case. Fixed if you want to just change it outright, and remove to, well, you know. The filters effect allows you to remove files and folders from the display. So if I check or uncheck the folders or files boxes, you'll see our display changes accordingly. Now, do you remember the folder checkbox from the numbering effect, Ace? Well, the manual says reset the auto number upon a change of subfolder. So if we check the subfolder box in the filters effect and check the folder box in the numbering effect, you'll see that a numbering resets when a new subfolder is hit. Marvelous. I'm going to move on since the other filters would need a whole video of their own. Copy move to location allows you to either copy or move the file to a specified path. The special effect is just that, Ace, and gives you the chance to change the file's attributes. I'm not going to go over these with you in this video, Ace, since this topic is long enough already. This has been a pretty thorough look at the bulk naming utility, Ace. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, Ace. I trust you'll like this utility. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any software suggestions. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.